Summer Rae. If you don't want to have her be on Raw, you can put her on SmackDown. If it doesn't work out on SmackDown, you can have her go between brands, and you can really try to create something with Summer Rae. Even if you don't know what to do with her character, you can really try to create and push the emphasis on Summer Rae, just as you did for Kelly Kelly back in 2008, 2009, when nobody really thought anything was going to be done with Kelly Kelly. She really turned things around, and the perception on Kelly Kelly's character really changed drastically, because she went from being someone who wasn't being taken seriously all the way to being WWE Divas Champion, and she held that title for over 4 months before she dropped the championship to a Beth Phoenix. The same thing can be done with Summer Rae, because if you give her time to improve on her in-ring skills and her abilities, you can really push her in storylines that actually make sense. You can actually see and picture Summer Rae versus Sasha Banks for that Women's Championship, rather than Summer Rae just being used as a putover girl, which is what we're merely seeing from Summer Rae now. She's just being used as a putover girl. She's in the ring with people like Sasha Banks and Charlotte, and she's always losing all the time. And that doesn't need to be happening for someone like Summer Rae, because there's a lot that you can do with Summer Rae's character if you just, you know, really push the emphasis on her character and really put her in our faces all the time and make us realize there's a lot of potential that goes with her character. There is a reason why I'm a Summer Rae fan, and you just have to figure out what that reason is. And I think I've given you enough proof as to why I'm a huge fan of Summer Rae, because there's a lot of potential that goes with her character in WWE, and it's just a matter of WWE realizing the potential that goes with her character. I don't think it's a matter of if they realize it or not. I think they realize the potential that goes with Summer Rae, because if they didn't realize the potential that goes with Summer Rae, they probably would have released her by now. It's just a matter of them testing the waters and being confident enough and really going full throttle with Summer Rae being involved in a storyline. She doesn't have to be involved. I said, you know, you can put her in a storyline with the likes of Dean Ambrose as his manager, where she's probably smitten with Dean Ambrose over the WWE title once the power and the money that goes with the WWE Championship. You don't really have to do that with someone like Summer Rae. You can have her manage the tag team champions on Raw or SmackDown. You can even do that if you want to. At least there's more emphasis on Summer Rae's character and more attention being given to Summer Rae than what's being given if she's just merely used as a putover girl. That doesn't need to be happening for someone like a Summer Rae. And if you're a Summer Rae fan who I know exists out there, that's the reason why I'm doing these video blogs, because I know there are a lot of Summer Rae fans that do exist out there, and you want to see more of an opportunity given to Summer Rae. I concur with your opinion on that. And because these Summer Rae fans do exist out there, they are out there on social media, they are sharing Summer Rae's content all the time, her photos, her videos, her interviews, whatever you are sharing on social media, I thank you for doing it. I know you exist out there, and that's why I'm trying to give you the benefit of the doubt and give you so much time in the spotlight, because Summer Rae deserves to have that spotlight on her, and I think that spotlight has been off of someone like Summer Rae for long enough. It doesn't need to be happening, and more emphasis needs to be put on a character like Summer Rae, because she has a lot of potential that goes with her character. We're just waiting to see that character shine through and the potential really be shown by Summer Rae that hasn't been shown for far long enough. I think it's gone without recognition for far long enough, and something needs to be done with her character. Looking at her as a manager of a team like Breezango, when you're talking about Tyler Breeze and Fandango, let me say this. You know, having her as the manager of Tyler Breeze was not enough. We wanted more out of Summer Rae. And you were telling us, you were trying to convince us that going all the way from being involved in a feud with Lana, Dolph Ziggler, and Rusev, that was talked about by TMZ. It was all over TMZ. The excuse you had for Summer Rae was to go all the way from that to being the manager and valet of Tyler Breeze, which was nothing. If you were going to do something with Tyler Breeze, you would have done it long before now, and I don't think anyone was really into Tyler Breeze for long enough to take him seriously. And I think that because nothing was done with Tyler Breeze, you should have really ran with her being a reality star. You tried to convince us that this was going to work for Summer Rae. It didn't, when other things could have worked far better for Summer Rae than what this was. And I think that she just really suffered from a downward spiral. She was on a downward spiral from everything that had happened with her in her career. Now, a lot of people haven't taken Summer Rae seriously. I understand why you haven't taken her seriously, because you haven't seen enough emphasis on her character and somewhat of a push for Summer Rae, which I thought was going to happen by at least midway through last year. It didn't happen. I was really frustrated about it, because I was the biggest Summer Rae fan and supporter that you could have heard on YouTube. I really appreciated how there were fans out there who were letting their presence be felt in professional wrestling, letting us know that they did exist out there. I really appreciated that. And the thing is, I think we can see more fans of Summer Rae kind of gravitate towards her. I wish we would see more of a gravitational pull towards Summer Rae happening in the WWE Universe. And I'm hoping we see that not before far too long, because Summer Rae deserves to have a lot of emphasis on her character in WWE and be given somewhat of a push. If you can push someone like a Dana Brooke or a Sasha Banks, who is extremely more popular and way more over than a Summer Rae character ever was, you can do the same thing for Summer Rae. It can work for anybody in the WWE. Alexa Bliss, who I'm a huge fan of, Carmella, who I'm a huge fan of, Naomi, who I'm a huge fan of, so many women who I'm a huge fan of, and this new women's revolution. It's just a matter of giving it a chance and an opportunity to be showcased in a way that it's never been showcased before, and you can really get away with doing it and saying the things that you have about Summer Rae. I mean, you can just say that Summer Rae doesn't have a lot of potential. That's just an easy way of getting out and getting away from talking about Summer Rae, or having to write about her for your column on your website, either writing about her for your column or posting a video blog, say, on your YouTube channel, just for the sake of posting a weekly video blog and review. But the thing is, you really have to go in depth about Summer Rae. You have to have more focus on Summer Rae. You just can't post photos and videos of someone like a Summer Rae and think you're going to get away with it and get out of having to talk about it, because there's a lot of potential that goes with her. And posting a photo, a shoot, or a video of Summer Rae every once in a while on the Daily Diva on WWE.com, or just having her as the photo of the day or whatever, or the video of the day on your website, is just one way of looking at it. It's a lazy excuse for not having to talk about her and getting out of having to talk about her, because you know there's a lot of potential that goes with her. And I think that people are just, you know, living in the shadows when it comes and staying in those shadows when it comes about to Summer Rae. And I think it's been happening for far long enough. It's ridiculous how so many people are not talking about her and giving her the time of day, and I wish more people would jump on that Summer Rae fan wagon, which I hope is going to happen in the next couple of months, because it deserves to be happening. And if there ever was a time to be a fan of women's wrestling and to be a fan of Summer Rae, it is now, in the fallout of the 2016 WWE brand extension between both Raw and SmackDown. That time is now, and I hope that more people choose to give her more emphasis and give her the spotlight as time goes on here. I'm hoping that the fan base, the fan wagon, so to speak, or so to say, expands for someone like Summer Rae. It needs to happen. It needs to happen for Summer Rae now. If it's going to happen anytime, it needs to happen now. And I think it's been put off for far long enough. And that's why I'm saying that Summer Breakout is going to happen, regardless if it happens now or 6 months down the road. It is eventually going to happen in WWE, and we are really going to enjoy it when it finally happens. And if you are not a Summer Rae fan, then you should be. If you're not a fan of the women's division in WWE in the way that it's being perceived now, you should be, and you should take advantage of the opportunity that lies before you, because we've never seen this opportunity presented before, and when it's presented to us, while it's being presented to us, we should take full advantage of it. It's not that I don't have respect for people like Sasha Banks, Nia Jax, and Charlotte, who are some of the forces that are carrying division and making things happen, because I do. I have respect for the women that are making things happen for the division, just as I have that same amount of respect for an Alexa Bliss, a Carmella, a Summer Rae. It's just, I think that more of an opportunity and more of a chance to be in that spotlight deserves to be happening for Summer Rae, and I would like to believe that I can get away with having said everything that I have that pertains to Summer Rae for this week on my show. If you've got a thought, you can get in on the conversation throughout social media. That's where the conversation is taking place, on my Facebook page at HCW Entertainment, on my Twitter at JonathanClark1, on my YouTube at JonathanClark22, and on my Google Plus at HCW Entertainment. Some of the ways you can get in on the conversation, and give me your thoughts if you've got any. I'm your host, Jonathan Clark, hoping for a summer breakout in WWE, and I'm hoping that we see that within the next 6 to 8 months, and I hope that you're one of these fans that concur with me when it comes to my opinion on Summer Rae, because my opinion on Summer Rae has been very vocal, at least over the last year and a half, and I would like to believe that I can get away with having said everything that I have about Summer Rae within the last 6 through 8 months, and I'm hoping that at least within the next 6 to 8 months through a year, we see something better done with Summer Rae. So I'll throw this video up on my YouTube channel. I'll be throwing the podcast up in the radio form on my website for you to get in on the conversation about, and let's hope that something more promising happens for Summer Rae, at least within the next year, because it deserves to be happening and has been overshadowed for long enough. It's time to get the ball rolling with Summer Rae, and it's time for us to see a summer breakout happening in WWE. I'm your host, Jonathan Clark, and I will check in with you again next week.
Like what you hear? Tell us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Hands.
empty hands in mine. And scars, show me all the scars you hide. And hey, if your wings are broken, please take mine so yours can open too. 'Cause I'm gonna stand by you.